Welcome. I am Michelle Riles, and I, along with Gary Mailer, are here today to discuss migrating your SAS 9 environment to SAS Viya. Let's talk about what migration is. Moving data and content from one environment to another. Now, this movement could be from a Viya to Viya environment, or it could be from a SAS 9.4 system to Viya. And today we're going to focus on the latter, moving from 9.4 to Viya. So why Viya? Well, we believe Viya is better. It not only tackles some of the most important challenges we hear from customers, maximizing business value, making better decisions, and delivering trusted outcomes, it does so by delivering these capabilities and tackling all of those challenges by way of cloud native, being easy to automate, continuous updates. These are just a few, and the reasons we believe that Viya is better. Today's emphasis is going to be on a term that we call SAS Global Migration Framework. This is a four-step plan. It starts with content assessment. These are downloadable applications we're going to discuss. We're going to run this tool and show you how that is done and what the output looks like. Next, we're going to spend time discussing the output created from this process in the form of reports, and that's going to help you with describing what's in your system. It's also going to help you evaluate a plan forward when you're making your decisions to migrate. And then finally, we're going to talk about the actual migration process, describing what will happen and how that plan can be visualized in something we call a migration roadmap. So let's talk about content assessment. We're going to start on the left-hand side over here. This is, like I said, a collection of applications. It includes inventory, profile, and code check. We start by looking at your existing 9.4 system and help you understand the content produced from that system. So inventory is going to count items by content type. It's going to detail this information and offer what products are installed and licensed on your system. Profile is going to help understand the features that are used, and it's going to describe detailed information about your objects and the relationships between those objects. SAS 9 Code Check is going to discover procedures used in SAS 9 programs that need to be updated or removed for compatibility with SAS Viya. We're also going to look at your hard-coded file paths and determine if they must exist on the new environment or be updated to work properly. So how do you get content assessment? It's very easy. We have a download page available. You're going to start by looking through the A to Z, navigate to S. You're going to look for the SAS content assessment, and the latest version will be there. Now, we frequently release updates to content assessment, and we encourage you to always check the downloads page for the latest release. So once you get your download completed, this is what you're going to see. You'll see that it's available on AIX, Linux, and Windows. There's also some helpful documentation available, a README. And then as you unzip or untar, depending on your platform, this is what you're going to see. There's a collection of directories for different modules, such as CodeCheck. We have some files that we're going to discuss that may need to be modified, metaparms.sass, setmv.yaml. In addition, there's some specific paths that if you want us to scan those, they can be listed in the pass list text file. The key here is the information is updated one time only. Each time you scan, you're not going to have to be required to enter those parameters over and over. So in preparing for content assessment, there are, as I mentioned, two files that you're going to be changing. The metaparm SAS file is going to tell us how to connect to your metadata server, and we're going to offer a password to encrypt the data we collect so that the data is shared with SAS. We're not going to have to worry about that being transferred in a non-secure way. We want that to be encrypted. And we encourage you to share this information with SAS so we can help you develop a migration plan and offer instructions. The setenv YAML file is where your SAS system's installed, normally SAS home, the location of the SAS configuration directory, and other locations where we might be looking for enterprise guide projects or other items in the file system. And at this time, I'm going to hand it over to Gary. He's going to demonstrate the steps in running the tools and navigate the reports detailing your environment assets. And we're going to start with inventory.
Thanks, Michelle. As we talked about before, inventory helps us count and collect data, and we're going to see how we do that now. We're going to run a script on your system and see how it looks and how the steps you would see going by your screen so we can collect the data for you. So I'm going to run a little video clip here. This is something we pre-recorded, but we're going to run the assessment tool. We're looking at the same directory that Michelle showed a little earlier. I'm going to run the first part called inventory content. And you'll see a couple of things scroll by on your screen. It doesn't take very long, and it will vary based on the size of your system, but we're looking through all the places you told us to look: your metadata server, file system paths where you might have content like enterprise guide programs or EG projects, SAS code, and other assets that you might have wherever they are on your system. And we're finished. We see that we're creating a data mart. You can see that creating data mart near the bottom of the page. The data mart is a collection of tables. That's what data marts are, and that's the collection of information we found from the scan, and that helps us in the next step, which is taking that data mart, uploading that to SAS if you'd like to, and then we can help you look through reports. These reports are gonna, we'll go through several of them interactively, and some of them I'll just show some static pictures of because they're just a little more complex to explain in the short window we have here. So what we'll see is interactively looking through one, and let's get that started. So as we saw a few minutes earlier, we ran the assessment tool. We ran the part that would tell us about the inventory, and I didn't show you, but we ran the other parts as well and collected data. Now we're going to look at it in a SAS Visual Analytics report. This is the inventory part where we'll start. Why we start with the inventory, it's sort of analogous to if you're moving your house to another house, sort of like migration. We want to make sure we know where everything is. If you have enterprise guide projects, where are they? And in this case, we want to make sure we know that some are in the metadata server and some are in the file system. And we can go and look where they are in the file system and make sure that they participate in the migration when it's time. So there's a lot of information here about the types of servers and databases and connectivity. This is really the first step to make sure that we know where everything is as we start planning our migration. To get into more detail, then we might go into profiling. There's a lot of aspects of profiling. I'm just going to show data integration here. We've run profiling on all the DI Studio jobs that we found in your system. And we look for things like how many DI jobs there are, how many generated transforms, and other sorts of features used in the product. When we look at transform usage counts, it really helps us understand the complexity of these DI Studio jobs where we're using extracts, joins, and other sorts of things based on frequency. This can help us guide the order in which we want to start the migration of DI Studio jobs, perhaps starting with some simpler ones and getting into others where we know we have the data ready in terms of creating data and loading it and then consuming it in ETL processes. So there's a lot of things we can find out in profiling. This is an example of what we look for in DI Studio jobs. Last module we'll look at is the results from CodeCheck. What we do in CodeCheck is look at code in a lot of places, SAS programs, or we can also pull things out of enterprise guide projects, DI Studio jobs, or stored processes. And these help us see what features of code were used in terms of procedures, libraries, and other sorts of things. When we look at things that might not be compatible, we can see that there are a couple of functions that we don't necessarily use anymore, like metadata server or the SAS Iola engine. That was something we used with Visual Analytics on SAS 9. Now we use a CAS engine. So these are pieces of syntax that would need change to get over to VIA. So this is a tool that'll help us find those things and know what needs to change in your world as you're migrating. The last thing we'll look at is hard-coded paths. There may be lots of reasons for these: lib name statements, file name, include, or infile statements. They can point to all kinds of places on your file system. And we want to be sure that as you're planning again your migration, we don't leave any data behind. So if these are different directories, we want to make sure we can help you understand where the data is in, say, your on-premise world to make sure we can get it safely to your cloud environment. So having done that, I'm going to show you a couple more pictures of other sorts of things we get from content assessment reports. So in addition to what I showed you during the live demo, here's a couple of static screenshots showing some of the information we can drill a little deeper. The inventory shows a lot of information about where the assets are, things like where enterprise guide projects are, that's grouped under analytics, things for customer intelligence, business intelligence, and other portfolios you may have licensed and have created content for on your system. When we look at profiling results, it's a little more complicated. Like Michelle said, we're not just counting and telling you where things are. We're now looking inside to see what's in your system. So these are the things that we're going to look inside, like reports, information maps, OLAP cubes, DI Studio jobs, to name a few, and more. And we can look inside these things and help assess whether these things will be difficult or require special attention during the move to Viya. And we'll go through a couple of those examples now. So for instance, if I'm looking at Web Report Studio content, in the left side of the pane, we can see whether we are using embedded data or data from OLAP cubes. That will be relevant as we help you plan understanding how to get your data moved from your SAS 9 system to Viya. On the right upper part, we can see which graphics have been used, graphs, list tables, cross tabs, just as an inventory to know how many things are there, and we can be sure that all that content makes it to the other side, including things like stored processes and other things you'll use to collect your data with. Here's a little more advanced example for Enterprise Miner. When we think about modifying and migrating Enterprise Miner projects, there's a lot of complexity in terms of the models you use. You can see some of those listed along the upper left and lower left side. And then the colors show how many of different types of methods and other parameters have been set as we're looking at things in Enterprise Miner. So there's a lot to see here when we're looking at profiling. And I'm gonna go to the next one. Finally, CodeCheck. CodeCheck is another really interesting program where we can see how different things panned out in terms of your use of SAS procedures or file system paths. Some of the procedures may need attention to make sure they work perfectly fine in Viya, and the file paths may need attention to make sure that we can migrate the data that those file paths look for. Sometimes they might be data sets or catalogs or SAS programs that are included. We have a module that will help us find all of those things and make sure they can make the transition successfully. In this picture here, we are looking at some of the things that might want to take attention. Metadata, for instance, although we lived with a metadata server on SAS 9, that's not a construct we use on SAS Viya. We use a different method for storing and retrieving things, so we want to be sure we know where those functions were used so they can transition to the new functionality on Viya. So there's a lot of things we can look at when we look at the results, and I hope you see that there's a lot of value here, and now we can take it to the next step of how we're going to use that information. There's the hard-coded paths we wanted to pay attention to. And now we can take it back to Michelle, and she's going to tell us about some of the more details about what gets migrated to what when we're moving from SAS 9 to Viya.
Perfect. So we're going to talk about, as Gary said, understanding this environment. Viya is a little different environment. It's cloud-centric. You're going to notice changes as you move, such as new object types that we are going to discuss. You'll notice differences in applications. The desktop applications that you're used to using are not going to do well in a cloud environment, so these have been replaced with an application called SAS Studio. So let's look at some of these object comparisons. As you know, there are many objects in SAS 9. DI Studio jobs, once used in the DI Studio application, are now going to be flows within SAS Studio. Similar environment, similar functionality, and migration will modify the version 9 objects into a new flow object that's going to provide some of that same functionality. Similarly, Enterprise Guide projects were used in the Enterprise Guide application. Now these projects will also be migrated to flows and surfaced in SAS Studio. As we go down the list, we have Visual Analytic Reports. These are still reports with the latter version of VA on Viya. OLAP cubes and information maps. Items that are used with BI, they have different representations. They're generally migrated into jobs, but in some cases, data views where you're needing to perform analytics, such as hierarchies and calculated columns that you're used to in your OLAP cubes. Stored processes, you may have been running these with schedules. They're going to be turning in SAS jobs, similar functionality with prompts. The SAS jobs will be running and editing taking place in SAS Studio, but they are stored as SAS jobs. So we've talked about SAS Studio quite a bit. This is the unified integrated development environment. In your 9.4 system, you have used SAS Enterprise Guide. You've used SAS data integration to handle your code generation, or you've been managing your code manually. Now SAS Studio is going to offer a web-based interactive development environment for analytics and data management built for Viya new workloads. It's an all-in-one, providing an intuitive, flexible graphical interface with powerful process flow diagram. It's going to let you visualize and organize and maintain your work. It has a nice code editor, and it's the next generation of SAS Enterprise Guide for the cloud. It provides a built-in data management and data quality transformations. It has the same sort of logic for queries and flows, and you can find tasks to schedule. And it has built-in collaboration. This is going to allow you to manage your source code with Git, and it's going to provide the ability to create shared tasks and code snippets that could be reused by others. So as we're discussing this, we want to talk about the path moving forward. So we're going to talk about how your code, your stored processes, Enterprise Guide projects, and DI Studio jobs move forward. They are all becoming SAS Studio flows with different levels of functionality. We're currently working to ensure all of your existing SAS code just works in the new environment. Any stored process that you have in SAS 9 should just run. These should just work. So we're going to make the prompts you previously used better, so you have full parity, so that the prompts and dynamic lookups, for example, will work without issue in Viya. We already have quite a bit of this functionality working. For Enterprise Guide, our first priority, again, is ensuring your code runs. And over time, we're going to be providing the more point-and-click interfaces for things such as queries, but we need to ensure the code's support is there initially. Similarly, with Data Integration Studio, we're migrating those jobs to SAS Studio flows and focusing on code first, which means we plan to provide comparable DI Studio transform like query and join in the form of SAS Studio code nodes. So let's talk about an example migration timeline. We've gathered assets, and this has helped with this, and it'll better enable us to develop a flow for how your migration is going to take place. Maybe you started already with SAS Studio because you can run code there. You might want to start thinking about incorporating your EG projects in the first quarter. Maybe in the second quarter, you start working on the Data Integration Studio jobs, the basic migration functionality there that's available. And then the last part of the year, maybe you want to focus on your Enterprise Guide and your DI Studio advanced migration. That's going to have different ways of translating queries and other objects so that you get full use of the point and click UI in SAS Studio moving forward. In summary, we're here to help. We believe that the applications that are provided are going to help you with your planning. It's going to detail the environment that you have to help you make better decisions moving forward. We believe Viya is the better choice for the reasons stated earlier. Moving towards the cloud, we've got SAS Studio that's going to benefit you as well. And we want to work with you. So we do encourage you to share your data and let us help you with developing this roadmap to help you get underway with migrating your SAS 9 environment to SAS Viya. And with that, we're going to move into the question portion of our presentation.